Today we celebrate the feast of the most holy body and blood of Christ, or as it has been traditionally known, the feast of Corpus Christi. Today we, as a Catholic people, celebrate the real presence of the body and blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of God in the Eucharist, known as transubstantiation. Today we celebrate the full giving of self for others, so that those who receive can in turn give fully to others. At this point, some of us may be shaking our heads and going, remind me about transubstantiation. Is that like consubstantial? Others may say, what you mean? Or what do you mean? Huh? Or just simply close off minds and hearts. Transubstantiation, God entering into reality in a new and dynamic way. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, present to us in the Eucharist. The real presence. God is with us in our bread and wine. Become body and blood. What you mean is how some young people might respond to a prompt or instruction with which they disagree. The response demands of the person asking to reframe what appears to be clear and logical. I get that from our students sometimes. What you mean? Rather than say, I do not understand or I disagree, their response puts the burden on the asker rather than the ask. Huh, or closing off minds and hearts, does the same thing. The person has to do more to try to get the other to understand or respond. We have to be open to what is shared with us. What is revealed with us in this Eucharist, in this real presence, in this gift. While the question, what do you mean, can be an invitation to deeper understanding and shared meaning, all of the responses often indicate closing off the self to what has been said, what has been offered. So today is an opportunity for us to deepen our understanding of what we are about to experience, a deepening of our commitment to what is asked of us as Christians. We close ourselves off at times because we do not want to respond as we are asked or called to do so. But that is who we are, whether we acknowledge it and embrace it, or we tend to shut ourselves off. We, brothers and sisters, were created by a loving God who through the fullness of time has brought all creation into being, and who in the fullness of time will bring all of creation back to God's love. God gave life to the human family, and in response we turned away, as you can see in the beautiful mural behind me. How did God respond to our sinfulness? Did God turn away from us, shutting off his love from the human family? No. God sent his only begotten Son, Jesus, into the world to save us through the forgiveness of our sins. God did not leave us alone. God did not abandon us. God, who had given us everything, gave us more. We who were created in the image and likeness of God, now we're given witness to God with us, Emmanuel. And even when Jesus was put up on a cross, giving himself totally over to the human family so that we would know how much God loved us, God did not stop there. God loved us more. The Holy Spirit was sent as our advocate to watch over us and guide us and strengthen us so that we could carry on the work that the disciples had begun with Jesus. We, carry on the work of loving others and caring for others simply because it's the right thing to do. We reveal to others the love that God has for them so that they can go and love others. That is our Christian mission. There is no confusion on that. There is no huh or why or when or what you need. As a Christian people in this feast of Corpus Christi, we emphasize the joy of the Eucharist, being the body and blood of Jesus Christ, the joy of being in the real presence of Jesus Christ. We participate in God becoming more real to us out of what is already real to us. So then when we go out into the real world, we can look for God trying to be more real for us. God is here. What does that mean? It means that in this very moment and every moment when we encounter the Eucharist is another moment to encounter God and to be transformed, renewed, filled with the joy that overflows into the world. The love that Jesus shared with the world overflowed into the world. The love that Jesus shares with us today must also continually overflow into the world today and every day. That is what we get to do. Be a part of that real presence. Now, like the Hebrew people, we might proclaim that we will do everything that the Lord has told us. But do we do it with joy and hope and expectation that we can do more than we realize, that we too can give ourselves fully to others and not be made less, but be made more? Jesus has both instituted and sealed the new covenant with his body and with his blood. Jesus, the living bread come down from heaven, gives us new life and life to the full if we follow him. Today, I invite you to hear again, to hear anew the words of Jesus. Take this, all of you in need of it, for this is my body. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Do this in memory of me. Remember Jesus. Remember all that he has done and promises to do for us. For you and you and you and me, for us. Brothers and sisters, be filled with the joy and hope and life and salvation that are made real again here today. Be Christ for the world. Let your lives overflow for the lives of others. God be praised for the body and blood.